family. We are here in the greenhouse today and we're having lots of questions around lighting and which plants like lots of light and which plants like more of a low light situation. So I have a few different plants here that are my favorites. And then I want to just sort of give you a little bit of advice on where to put these in your home so that you can be successful with these. So first off, we're going to start with a low light plant. Now a low light plant is usually generally a place that still has a window, okay? So you still need to have a window to have a low light plant in your home. And usually that window is about an east or a north facing window in that room. Now a low light plant, especially in the winter season, can be right against a north or an east window and that's still considered to be low light. So remember, we're getting very, very few hours of daylight in the winter time. So getting those plants as close to the window and a natural light source is so, so good. You can also supplement with an artificial light source like a grow light too, and we have lots of options for there. So see us in our plant solution department in our greenhouse if you're interested in some grow lights, and we can walk you through some steps of how you can keep your plants actively growing with a grow light. Remember, in the winter season, our plants are not really actively growing. So all these low light plants I find are most successful. So if you're a new gardener and you want to start out with a plant in the winter, choose a low light plant, even if you have a bright room. A lot of our low light plants will actually survive in a bright, bright room in the winter time. And I find that you'll have better success with them. So some of my favorites here for a low light situation and easy to care for is the ZZ plant. I have some Dracaenas which have some great, bright, vibrant colors. A Calathea, if you're a little bit more of a gardener's challenge, these guys like high humidity and low, low light. One of these guys is, this is a Peace Lily or a Spath, and these are my, if I have a beginner gardener, I want to start off with a Peace Lily. They'll kind of talk to you and droop when they start getting wet. So they're easy to care for and a low light plant too. And then one of my favorites, easy care for, I have one of these in my kids' bedroom. Almost all my kids have one of these in their bedroom where they're so, so easy. And they have actually like to keep their blinds closed quite a bit too. So the snake plant is also a great low light plant. Now when we get into our highlight plants, these ones are for your rooms where you have a nice, huge south or a west facing window. And your plants are close to that window. So even if you have a big south or west facing window and your plants are on the other side of the room or on the other side of a piece of furniture, that may be considered a low light area. So really watch around like 2 or 3 o'clock in the afternoon and where those sunbeams are actually shining. You will want to see direct sunlight on them for a highlight plant for them to stay actively growing, especially in the winter season. And you'll want at least 8 hours of that sunlight on those plants for the highlight plants. Otherwise, you'll want to be supplementing with a grow light. Some of the plants I have chosen here for a highlight area to show you are my Croton. I love the color of this, and the more light you have it, the brighter it's going to be. This guy here can handle the direct light. If you have a Birds of Paradise and you have it off to the side and you notice the leaves are drooping a little bit, it might need more light. So make sure you put this one right in a south or west window. A lot of us might have picked up a nice citrus plant, and I find even in the brightest window in the wintertime, unless you're getting supplement light, it will go dormant for you, which means that it's gonna drop its leaves. You'll see this a lot with our weeping figs as well. They will drop up to a third to half of their leaves in the wintertime. This is a normal process. Remember that these plants, just in nature, just like our leaves fall off our trees in the fall and winter season, they will do that indoors when they go dormant too. So don't be afraid that you're killing your plant. That's a normal process for it. Once we start getting more daylight hours, increase your fertilizer and that plant will start getting that new leaf on it. And one thing that's really cool is sometimes when it's dropped all those leaves, you'll actually get a few pieces of fruit on it. So it looks like it's a bald plant with a big piece of fruit on it, but it's kind of fun in the winter season. And the last one I've chosen here to show you is a yucca plant. It is your most commonly looked at plant to make it look like a desert in your home. Easy to care for, but again, it loves the bright light and it will need that bright light to survive and thrive long term. Now, if you're wanting a plant and putting maybe a low light plant into a highlight area or a highlight plant into a low light area, it will last there for a period of time, but eventually the plant's gonna be slowly decaying and disappearing on you. So if you want a plant for more aesthetic purposes for a short-term area, you can really put any plant into any area that you want. Just remember that that's most like a long-term floral arrangement. So you're gonna be successful with that plant in maybe a really low light area for about 8 months to a year, and then you're gonna start seeing the effects of the plant not having as much light. So if you're wanting that and you're wanting it just maybe to showcase a home or to stage a home, you can definitely do that and put that plant that's maybe highlighted in a more low light situation, but make sure that you know that it's only gonna last there for about up to a year max. So there you have it, highlight versus low light, where to have it in your home. I'm gonna put some pictures on here that will show you a little bit of an image. I am a very visual person, so an image of, as to how you can sort of place plants in your home so that they will survive the best for you. I hope you've enjoyed these tips and tricks. Come visit us on our website, dutchgrowers.com, or under the windmill, Atchison Central, Saskatoon.